I wanted to say some things about failure. I've always been obsessed with failure, with death, with suffering. These things seem like all we have in this world sometimes. If you look at what makes us forward, moving, what drives us, it's always these things and your reaction to them. This negative ground, this negative field, this fleshy substance. One thing must eat the other. One thing must run into the other's mouth so that the other may live. One thing must constantly give itself to another. And so there is not an equality. There never has been. There is only violence. And there is a solution. But it's an individual choice, and not everybody makes it. And for most people, it's placed as this inachievable perfection, a reality so far from them that they could never, ever get there. And so they know failure, and they wait for death. I have a secret teaching. It is that if you make a friend of failure and a friend of death, you have nothing to fear. Failure and success are equal. Your success is your failure. What has your success done for you? What has it done for others? Most of you can say that you have fancy things, you have a good life. You have lots of fun. Good for you. Everyone is good to have that. Others don't have that. Others have even less than that. And they have it so that you will have what you have. You say, no, no. Where would this world be without suffering? What would your economy be without suffering? Where would your jobs go when there was no one to teach, no one to lock up, no one to kill, nothing to eat? What would you do then if you were all happy and you did not need to drown yourselves in entertainment? If all you had to do was go outside with your family, and everyone had a home, and food just came up out of the ground, what would you do then? Most of you cannot imagine a world where things are natural and normal. You cannot imagine what you would do unless there were so many broken people for you to deal with. I don't want to deal with broken people. If you see me in the world, and you see the people who I have gravitated toward, it's not because they're broken. It's people who have nothing. They are the ones who know the way. They don't know it. They live it. The rest of you run. You hide yourselves. You hide yourselves behind a cloak of success. You think that your achievements and your knowledge, your special doings, that is what makes you free. That is what makes you great. That is what makes you here and now. And Yet you judge yourselves in terms of the past and the future only. And you think that your life comes down to simple chemical equations, atomical structures, a reality beyond you, either way out there or way in here. One way or the other, it's never face to face. It's never in the reality you share with other people. There is a truth beyond all of these things that you do not want to hear. And that is that the reality you see is the reality which is in front of you. And it is what it is. Whether there are conspiracies or not there to explain it, conditions which you observe are the same. This world is in absolute suffering, and there is purpose in that. But why? 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 Why do you do what you do? That is what you need to think, and you must not fail there.